First of all, I need to tell you a few words about the consortium, because this is quite a unique group of partners for the project of this type. That was a project of a company measure form, so it was not scientific research actually, but it was a company project. And it was quite unique because there were a unique combination of partners. There were three big networks. A coordinating network was ELANET, it's European Local Authorities Network, and the Council of European Municipalities and Regions. Then there was another big network of regions, European Regional Information Society Association. And then in the committee of advising committee, we were using also telecities. And then we had nine European regions involved. And here you could see the Czech region Vysočina, which was involved through a civic association BMI. It's interesting that one of the results, for example, of this cooperation in the Czech Republic, there was a creation of new organization, EPMA, which is half public, because this cooperation of civic association, BMI and region was quite fruitful, so the partners had decided to continue in future in a larger scale of topics. So the prelude itself is now over. It's finished in the year 2003. But because till the end of the project, all these partners were still attractive new other partners. So next 11 regions expressed their wish to join this tremendous work. So actually we were continuing relations, activities after the end of the project, and they are still running till now and finishing at the end of this year under the frame of Prelude Challenge Grid. Speaking about clusters, I've decided to explain you this peculiar idea and practical experiment of Prelude partners, because it was quite hard, and I suppose we could follow a lot of separate topics inside this cluster forming process and learn a lot. First of all, we have started with setting 20 clusters of different areas. They were predominated or pre-selected by nine digital areas stated at the project. We understand cluster in this project as organized group of local actors at regional level, working in the field of information society with the research and innovation plan, and this is essential. We demand the plan is on table, that it's created. Then based on the ICT use and carried out by one or more public-private partnerships. This is also essential understanding of cluster. Through these 20 clusters, there was a competition of most successful and vital of them. We have created in the second half of the project nine European clusters. Looking at the matrix of creating, we could see at the bottom, there are Prelude regions. They are local partners which were working on the basic level of creating clusters. Then there were some towns in telecities from telecities network that were promoting and joining our work. Then we had ELANET with a huge amount of municipalities and public administration organizations, and ERISA regions. Through all these partners, we were building these clusters, and it was quite hard, I could tell you. So the core group in each cluster was created by businesses, first of all, which are involved and responsible for development and mastering of technologies. And this was very different in different regions, according with local needs, demands and conditions. Then we had government bodies, politicians. It was absolutely essential for the visibility of the work and for maintaining real touch with the real life of the clusters. Then we invited, and the condition was to have research institutions and organizations in a cluster, which really ensure scientific competence. And of course, NGOs were very active as well, and all kind of non-profit organizations. To this core heart of local cluster, we then add European partners. We've got European clusters for innovation. What was the essence of our approach? The idea was to improve regional innovation capacities and to introduce new habits in the understanding of innovation process. Then for us it was essential to have this so-called triple helix approach, to have different partners, different types of innovation, because normally we understand innovation only from technical point of view. But as our discussions have found that we need also organizational innovation and a lot of changes on the verge of social changes, and even political innovation is welcomed. We were asking for a structured plan for activities of such interactions, and we were seeking for real commitment of actors so that clusters will continue their existence. The most hard was to find the balance between economical and social parts of this cluster building. Here is just a picture which shows you that we try to put quite a scientific approach in this cluster building process. So we started with a regional analysis. This analysis of the capacities in different regions was connected with questionnaires about project existing, about key players, about key facilitators in each region. We've got a lot of certain cases, and have created a project gallery, which is still possible to enter through our website. And the project gallery is not actualized anymore because we have found that it's not interesting now, but it was quite useful for the first year of running of a project. And you have still an example of more than 150 projects from different parts of Europe. Then we pushed the clusters to make the strategy of action, and regional clustering was set. Then they start to expand, and after self-analysis and self-evaluation, they have become, the most vital of them have become European. Our experiences showed us that European regions need a lot of new impulses. During this cluster building, some of clusters used a really innovative models. For example, Eden cluster about a business introduced, and it was then widely used in different other clusters, a digital ecosystem model. Such examples are essential for regions which probably are not so on the top of knowledge what is going on in scientific area. And on the other side, we have found that in spite of big differences in levels of economical development and of understanding of things, our regions are facing very comparable and probably similar problems in the area of, for example, all of them are feeling the big crisis of bureaucratic model of governance. They were asking for new demands and listening to citizens, which were asking for new kind of services. All of them expressed the need to monitor and understand better the topic of public expenditures. Each region was asking about return of investment in a different kind of projects, and of course about public value of such project. It means that economic understanding of European cooperation is not so strong. And then the issue of European integration. We have found, as a prelude experience, that Europe needs a new kind of social re-engineering, new socio-economic architects who understand the role, place and functions of ICT. And first of all, such people are quite essential for the work of public administration, first of all at regional level, because they could combine these competencies of ICT knowledge, innovation, and understanding of social and political needs in regions. And then that effective cooperation of real regions is possible using the best knowledge from virtual space. And this is about this digital ecosystem model. So here you have the list of final 9 European clusters for innovation, and at the top you see those who still are very, very active. It means that they are producing not only meetings, discussions and some real interactions, but they are producing projects at regional level and international level. Eden cluster is about a business, and it's facilitated by northern partners from Finland and Switzerland. ETTC cluster, it's about transportation, and it's led by a German Berlin Transport Institute. It's a very strong cluster. Gaudi cluster is a government. It's quite reshaping cluster now, and we'll got some continuation in a new network of excellence, which will start from the 1st of January and called DemoNet. And the knowledge management cluster is working in different small projects. The others are still probably in a more preparation phase. Mobicity cluster was also quite successful with some project. The others are not so probably strong. And for example, Three Roses cluster was dedicated to open source, and the work is over with this cluster because it's split it in different kind of other activities. So what is essential that all these clusters are now living by their own life. So it means after the end of a project and after 2 years of continuation of so-called prelude grid, these clusters have become quite self-sufficient with their development. So this is just a few words about Gaudi cluster, how it appeared and how it was working in former times. You see here some partners, and it's still reshaping now in a democratic network. There are some words about priority areas in the government research, but I'm not sure that probably I will speak deeper about this. I suggest that if somebody is interested in this particular area, you could contact me, because our particular interest is in this area, and Visocina and the EPMA organization is working particularly more on this as a future partner for DemoNet. There are a few ideas about some funding in applied research areas. But I suppose most interesting will be to put some conclusions about our experiment with cluster building. And we suppose that for success of such experiment, it's essential to have a strong vision of shared social, economical, political goals. Then it's essential to create a big awareness for such process, creating a critical mass. Then it's essential to have knowledge and participation of also citizens and key stakeholders. Then speaking about our experiment and the conclusions about using of digital business ecosystem model, we could say that this is quite interesting for regions to experiment with the last scientific research and models. And they are quite critical to some conclusions. And our experiment shows that, for example, particularly this model, which was explained, for example, more I suppose in the year 2002, in some papers of European Commission representative Mr. Nahira, this model doesn't work or it's not enough for the regions. Regions are seeking for a wider concept, and we called it societal learning approach or societal learning model. And we finished actually the project with the idea to develop this model in future researches. What is it all about? It's about how to maintain this development of regions in a way that really all partners, all citizens are involved through one, two or other group. I mean that we have researchers who are putting their scientific researches working for the regional development, that we have public administration which understand the language of scientists, which is quite essential, and we have businesses which are implementing this or inventing their own things from technological point of view. And then we have citizens who are involved and supporting and participating in this process. There are probably some more information about particular problems which we have found in this using of digital ecosystem model. And we are now asking and seeking for this development of the line. For example, in the government cluster using this model, we state that e-government is already probably the old-fashioned model, that we are now seeking and speaking about e-governance and for the future about the whole concept of e-democracy. A few words at the end about CIR committee, which is the next outcome of our project. The idea to involve researchers and make them more work for the region finished with this creating of a CIR committee, it's Committee for Science, Innovation and Research. And they were offered 20 outstanding multidisciplinary researchers from each region to the committee, which gathered for discussing the most urgent and interesting topics which are essential for their regional development. At the same time, they are presenting high-level expertise, and they are professors with very quite interesting multidisciplinary experience in science. So we started this process, and we have one meeting, and now we are thinking how to continue, because actually we have no funding for such activity. But there you have some our basic ideas how such body could assist to European regions and to Commission to understand better the needs and the ability of regions, of public administrations, to absorb scientific results, to understand and to use them for their practical need. For us, it was very essential that this last point, that we will really put together political leaders and the public administration of all levels together with researchers, make them communicate together, and businesses also being present. So this, our experiment, was quite interesting. It's only started. You have here a few benefits from such a committee, and as we saw in the morning, the decision of Commission to organize European Research Council is probably also expressing this need and this demand, and we feel it like that in our consortium.